great or small. He knows my name, every step that I take, every move that I make, every tear that I cry. He knows my name when I'm overwhelmed by the pain and see the light of day, but I know I'll be just fine.
Aren't you so glad he knows you?
He knows my name when I'm overwhelmed by the pain and see the light of day, but I just know I'll be just fine. He knows my name.
Oh, hallelujah.
I don't know what tomorrow may bring.
Oh, no.
I can't tell you what's in store. I don't know these things. Don't have the answers to all the questions of life, but I know in who I have believed.
Oh, yeah.
And he knows my name, every step that I take, every move that I make,
aren't you so glad? Church, to the Lord knows you by name. Hallelujah. Do you know when Jesus called Lazarus, amen, out of the tomb, amen, glory to God, amen, amen, glory to God. Jesus knew Lazarus' name, amen. Glory to God, hallelujah, hallelujah. I don't know back then, it may have been another Lazarus, amen, I don't know. But that Lazarus, amen, hallelujah, when Jesus called him out, amen. Glory to God, hallelujah, hallelujah. You know, maybe, amen, many people here today or, amen, that may have the same, amen, name, amen. But when God speaks your name, amen, hallelujah, God knows, amen, each and every one of us by name, and he knows what we're going through, and he knows what we're facing, amen. And you know, nothing catches God by surprise, amen. It may catch us by surprise, it may, amen, make us, amen, turn some flips, amen, but God knows, amen. And he said in his word, amen, amen, he'll put no more on us what we can bear, amen. And I don't know what you're going through this morning, friend, but I know there's a God in heaven that loves you, amen, and he cares for you, amen, and he knows every number, amen, on your head, amen. And just sitting there, amen, and I'm like, God, you know every number that comes out, amen, of my hair, amen, but that's all right, amen. The same God that let it grow before, amen, the same God I let it grow again, amen, because God knows, amen. Glory to God. And you know, God has no respect of person, amen, and amen. Don't want to talk too much about myself this morning, because it's not about me, amen. It's all about the Lord, amen. But I say, Lord, if I could, you know, if you want me to identify with other people, amen, Brother Clay, amen, that don't have any hair, amen. Glory to God. I say, well, Lord, let it be, amen. You know, because we're none exempt this morning, Amen. We're none exempt, amen, cancer or sickness, amen. You know, amen, but I thank God, amen, that he has faith and confidence in me. And he has faith and confidence in you, church, to allow you to be going through, amen, what you're going through, amen. God sees and God knows and God cares, amen, and God understands, amen. Amen. I may not know today, amen. The pastor may not know, amen, today. And we don't have to know, amen. But there's a God in heaven, amen, that knows you by name. And he knows what you're going through, amen. And he knows what you're facing, amen. Glory to God. And thank the Lord for the good news today, amen. His grace is sufficient, amen. Glory to God. He said that he would never put no more on us, amen, than what we could bear. Amen. Friend, God's got faith and confidence in you this morning, amen, that you could go through it, amen, and you could overcome it, amen, not within yourself, amen, but through and by Christ Jesus, amen. If we would keep our hand, amen, in the nail-scarred hand, amen, God's going to see us through, amen. Brother Don, I got that faith and confidence in my God. I don't know about your God, amen, because I don't know, amen, exactly what God has done for you, amen. Only what you tell me, amen, today, amen, but I know what God has done for me. I know what my God, amen, what has God done for you this morning, amen? If God's done something for you, amen, why don't you give him some praise, amen? Why don't you give him some praise today, amen? If God's done anything for you, amen, you may not be saved here this morning, friend, but God woke you up this morning, amen, with life and with breath, amen. Glory to God. I'm so glad this morning that God knows my name, amen. And I'm so glad, amen, that I know him today, amen. I'm so glad that he loves me, amen, just because, amen, of me this morning, amen, with all my falters and all my fails, amen, and yes, amen, sometimes I sin, but I thank God that I have an advocate, amen, with the Father, amen. And you may be here this morning, you don't know the Lord as your personal Savior, amen, you could get to know him, amen. Glory to God, hallelujah. If you listen closely this morning, God's calling your name, amen. God's calling for you, amen. Glory to God, just like he called for Lazarus, amen. Amen, hallelujah. Lazarus was dead, amen, but Lazarus knew God. Amen. You may be here, friend, dead in your sins this morning. Amen, but if you listen closely, amen, God's calling your name. He's calling you out today, amen. All you have to do, amen, glory to God, amen, is come down to this altar of repentance, amen, and ask God to forgive you, amen. Jesus loves you, friend, and he knows everything about you this morning. God's concerned about you, amen. You may be here this morning and feel like no one loves you, and no one cares, and no one's concerned, and nobody knows what you're feeling through, amen. And that may be true this morning, amen. But Sister Angie, I'm so glad, amen, that there's a God in heaven, amen, that loves me and he loves you, friend. And God has no respect to person, amen, this morning, amen. Glory to God. Just because we know the Lord as our personal Savior this morning, and you may die, amen. Glory to God, but you could this morning, amen. Glory to God. Brother Daniel, sing the song. I'm so glad that he knows my name. Glory to God. Sister Wendy, he knows my pain. He knows our pain. Amen. This morning, I'm so glad he does. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's worship him.
Every move that I made, all the tears that I cried, he knows. I'm overwhelmed by the pain, can't see the light of day, but I know I'll be just fine. He knows my name, every step that I take, every move that I make, every tear that I cry. He knows my name when I'm overwhelmed. But I know I'll be just fine. He knows my name.
Amen. I'm so thankful that he knows us by name. Amen. Glory to God. Brother Donald, if you'd be so kind, amen, to present the offering. Amen. Hallelujah. We want to Amen. Go ahead and turn the service over our pastor. I want to give him plenty of time. Amen. I want to give us plenty of time for dinner and for some rest. And I'll be back at 4 o'clock to worship the Lord. Amen. Glory to God. If you're not standing, if you're able to stand in reverence to the Lord, pray God I bless you many fold. So good to have Brother Bobby Creel. Brother Bobby, if you like, blessing the offering this morning for us, sir.
Praise the Lord. Amen. For the next 20 minutes or so, I want you to turn with me, if you would, in your Bibles to the book of 1 Thessalonians. 1 Thessalonians. First Thessalonians chapter 4. Amen. Somebody say praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now y'all don't get quiet on me now. Y'all were, well, they didn't back you too much, brother, but amen. Y'all quiet. Y'all sponges today. Amen. Absorbing the Word of God. Amen. So we appreciate that. Amen. We want to absorb the Word of God. Let's take a look at 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. I want to read verse 3 through 12. I want to read that this morning, and then I want to, I've been wanting to minister this series that I did in a revival probably a year and a half ago, amen, and the Lord has now given me to go ahead to start this series, amen. I believe the Lord wants to help us, amen, to understand His desire for the body of Christ, amen, hallelujah. Let me read the text, and then we'll go right into the preaching of the Word after we pray. The word of the Lord says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 3, "For this is the will of God, even your sanctification, that ye should abstain from fornication, that every one of you should know how to possess his vessel in sanctification and honor, not in the lust of concupiscence, even as the Gentiles which know not God, that no man go beyond and defraud his brother in any matter, because that the Lord is the avenger of all such, as we also have forewarned you and testified. For God hath not called us unto uncleanliness, but unto holiness. He therefore that despiseth not man, but God, who hath also given unto us his Holy Spirit. But as touching brotherly love, ye need not that I write unto you, for ye yourselves are taught of God to love one another." Boy, I'm telling you, we was all over it in Sunday school, wasn't we? Amen. Verse 10. "And indeed ye do it toward all the brethren which are in all Macedonia. But we beseech you, brethren, that ye increase more and more, and that ye study to be quiet." Come on, amen. Don't be quick to retaliate, but be meek and lowly, humble and holy, following the Lamb. Come on, amen. "And to do your own business, and to work with your own hands as we command you," or commanded you, "that ye may walk honestly toward them that are without." Come on, he's telling us that we need to be an epistle to others, a book to others, "and that ye may have lack of nothing." Hallelujah. Amen. So this morning, We want to talk to you about purity, starting a series on purity and sanctification. Purity and sanctification. Just for a little while, I want to minister on that. Amen. If you would stretch your hand this way, pray with us, pray for us. Amen. Go ahead and begin praying. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Help us today, Lord. Touch us today, Lord. Let our hearts be open to receive your word. Holy Ghost, raise a standard against the enemy. Let there be liberty for the proclamation of your word, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Have your way, Lord, for the next few minutes, oh God. Use us for your glory, God. Touch us by your mighty power, Lord. Hallelujah. Let your word come forth to heal us, oh God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And everybody said, amen. Just for a few moments. Now, I notice some people are leaving already because it's 12 o'clock. Amen. But I'm so glad I got a group of folks that want to hear the word of God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I know that this world is about over, that the coming of the Lord is at hand. Come on. Amen. Because if you watch the news media, as I stated, amen, if you're not careful, amen, you'll be given to anxiety. You'll be overcome with surfeiting and drunkenness because of the affairs that are taking place in this world. Amen. Hallelujah. But as I stated already in the announcement portion of the service, God has not called us to follow after a donkey or an elephant, but he has called us out of darkness, out of this world, into his marvelous light, to follow after the Lamb. Can somebody say amen? Hallelujah. I've been called to follow after the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus said, if you're going to be my disciple, you must deny yourself and take up your cross daily and follow me. Can somebody say amen? Hallelujah. And so we want to talk to you on a series that I feel the Lord gave me a little over a year ago, a couple years ago, and there's some different messages, and you will hear some of the points out of those messages that I've preached and ministered, amen, throughout the past few years. But about a year and a half ago, I was able to preach a revival last year sometime, and amen, and I was holding on to this. I said, Lord, we need this for the church too, amen, hallelujah. And I believe the Lord is, amen, giving me to go ahead for this morning to begin this series, amen. And as I stated on Wednesday night, we'll begin to talk about membership and why the church was founded and why our church is like it is and why we do the things that we do and so forth, amen. So it'll be preparing you if you want to be a member of the church. But how many of you know it's more important to be a member of the body of Christ? It's more important to be a member of the universal church. As I stated, you can be a member of 50 churches and still go to hell. Come on, amen. Hallelujah. I said you can be baptized in every, amen, lake or river or pool in Cottageville or Ridgeville, the surrounding areas, and you can still die and go to hell. Amen. Because the amen, water baptism doesn't save you. Getting your name on the church roll doesn't save you. Amen. But I'm telling you, if you'll repent of your sins and turn to the Lord Jesus Christ, amen, understand that he made that sacrifice on that cross for your sins. Hallelujah. If you appropriate the vicarious sacrifice of the Lord Jesus Christ, amen, and begin to develop a personal relationship with him, starting out by saying, God, I'm sorry of my sins, amen, forgive me of my sins, come into my heart and come into my life, take control, take the reins of my life, guide and direct my steps, help me in my daily decisions, amen, hallelujah. And you begin to walk in accordance to the word of God, being led by the Spirit of God, as the Lord forgives you of your sins and washes away all your sins, amen, he'll begin to guide you, the Spirit of God, into all truth, amen, in the ways of righteousness and the ways of holiness. Why do I say that? Because God is righteous, because God is holy. And I'm telling you, his church is going to be the same, amen. There's no way, amen, that we can get into heaven apart from the righteousness righteousness of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why, amen, you can't do good works and good deeds to get into glory. Amen. That's why Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. We must come in through and by the door, and his name is Jesus. Hallelujah. And when he calls your name, respond. No man can come uninvited. Amen. But as the Father draws us to the, amen, the luring of the Holy Ghost, the wooing of the Holy Ghost, we need to respond to the Lord and say, God, I'm sorry of my sins. Amen. I believe that you died for my sins on the cross. Forgive me of my sins, and you can be born again. Amen. You don't have to ask the pastor, am I born again? You don't have to ask a brother, am I born again? You don't have to ask a sister, am I born again? But I'm telling you, when you are born from above, when the blood of Jesus has washed away all those sins, amen, you will know that you've been born again. Can somebody give him praise in his house? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So, amen. How do we as members maintain purity? Come on, we live in a sin-sick world. Amen. We rub shoulders with the world. Come on, amen, with worldlings. Amen. We're Christians and we're in this world, but we're not of this world. Amen. So when we think about the word purity, and we're talking on this series about purity and sanctification, and when we're in this world and we consider the word purity, we must consider justification. Amen. And sanctification. Justification is just as if I had never sinned. In other words, it's being born again. When you're born again, you are justified through the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. And when you are justified, you are sanctified by the power of his blood. I'm telling you, you are holy and totally sanctified because he's forgiven you of all your sins. Amen. Come on, amen. But I'm telling you, he's going to give you a new heart and a new spirit. Amen. And cause you to walk in his statutes and his judgments. Amen. In his word and keep his commands. Amen. But there is a progressive sanctification. There is a pull of the world. There is a pull of Satan. There is a pull of the flesh. And there is a constant warfare within and without. Come on, amen. It's just like the children of Israel when they left Egypt. Amen. Pharaoh did not leave them alone, but Pharaoh got on their trail and he was trying to bring them back into bondage. But I'm telling you, if you make up your mind, as I preached, I believe, on last Sunday evening, amen, to go forward, to press forward in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You don't have to worry about Pharaoh. You don't have to worry about the devil. Come on, amen. Make up your mind that my hand is on the plow and I'm going forward in Jesus Christ. Throwing in the towel is not an option. Throwing up my hands to the enemy is not an option. But when I don't know what else to do, Brother Donnie, I'll just look to the Lord and throw my hands up to the Lord and start praising the Lord. Hallelujah. And when I praise him in the midst of my peril, when I magnify him, when I seem like I'm going down, he'll come down into the situation and lift me above my circumstance. He'll allow the Holy Ghost to be the wind beneath my wings, and I'll mount up with wings as eagle. Amen. I'll soar above the circumstances of my life, and I'll keep my focus on the Son, S-O-N. Come on, amen. I'll keep my eyes on Jesus. The Hebrew writer said, let us lay aside the weight and the sin that does so easily beset us, and let us look unto Jesus, run the race that's set before us, looking unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Can somebody give him praise? Come on, amen. Hallelujah. Y'all got to pray for me now. I'm already getting off. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. But we think about there's a progressive sanctification. But as I said, when you get born again, that's the best time to be baptized in the Holy Ghost. That's the best time because you're no more sanctified than you will ever be. Are you understanding what I'm saying? But there is a progressive sanctification. Amen. Thank God when we're born again, we're indwelt by the Spirit. But there is a distinction of being indwelt by the Spirit or receiving the Spirit of, amen, the Spirit of regeneration versus being filled with the Spirit. Amen. Or being baptized in the Spirit. Can somebody say amen? Hallelujah. So the blessing that we're going to talk about this morning, and we'll close this portion of this series out, this message, the blessing is salvation. God wants every man, woman, boy, and girl to receive the blessing of salvation. Hallelujah. Amen. And the righteousness, amen, not just, amen, and then there's righteousness, amen. God wants us to receive, amen, the blessing of salvation or justification, but he also wants us to understand that there is a walk in holiness. There is a walk in righteousness. There is a walk in purity. Hallelujah. When we think about righteousness, we must think about purity. We must think about sanctification, and we must think about holiness. Come on, amen. Pastor, you're going to preach on purity and sanctification. We haven't heard messages about purity and sanctification for years. Well, you're going to hear it in the next few series. Amen. Because I want to follow the plan of God. I'm telling you, God is trying to get the church, amen, cleaned up and separated from the world. I said, God's coming back for a church without spot, without wrinkle, amen, without blemish or any such thing. I'm telling you, amen, you don't want to be contaminated with the world. I'm telling you, the best way, amen, to become one that is not entangled with the webs of deceit of this world and of Satan is to be oiled down with the Holy Ghost, to make up your mind, and I want to be saturated in the anointing of the Holy Ghost. I want the oil of the anointing of the Spirit of God in my life. Come on, amen. On the job, in the home, in the marketplace, as they were talking about this morning, in Walmart, hallelujah, amen, when I'm in the parking lot and I see somebody just take that buggy and hit my car, they swing their door open and hit my car, come on, amen, or if I accidentally bump theirs with my elbow and they jump out the car and start fussing and cussing, I want to be able to stand up and be bold in the spirit and say, I'm so sorry, but I love you with the love of God, and right now we can just pray about the situation, and if you want me to give you some money, I don't have any right now, but give me your name and number and I'll send it to you. Come on, amen. Overcome that evil with good. Hallelujah. Overcome that hatred with love. Can somebody give him praise in his house? Hallelujah. So the blessing is salvation and righteousness. Thank God for salvation, but I'm telling you, you don't have to live like you used to. You don't have to follow after this world anymore. You're in the world, but you've changed citizenship now. And God is calling us to purity. He is calling us to sanctification. 1 Thessalonians, let's take a look at our text. The Bible said, for this is the will of God. Come on, amen. What is the will of God? How many of you want to do the will of God? This is the will of God, even your sanctification. Not the pastors, not just the evangelists, not just the deacon, but every member of the body of Christ. Hallelujah. He said, this is the will of God, even your sanctification. Amen. Hallelujah. That ye should abstain from fornication. Well, I don't have any problems then. You like the young rich ruler. Amen. I don't have a problem. Come on, amen. Because I'm not sleeping around with everybody. Come on, amen. But how many of you know there is a spiritual fornication? Come on, amen. There is a physical, literal fornication. If you're not married and the other person's not married and you have an intimacy in a way that you ought not to be having if you're not married, come on, amen. That is fornication, amen. A fornication, hallelujah. I want to say it like some of the folks up in North Carolina, amen. Hallelujah. But it's not fornication, amen. Are you with me? Amen. It is fornication. It is fornication. If you're having sex outside of marriage, but if you're married, then that's adultery. Or if you're single and that person's married, that's adultery. Are y'all with me? Amen. And we all understand that. But I'm telling you, there is something such as spiritual fornication. There is something such as spiritual adultery. Anytime we allow an idol in our lives, something to take preeminence over Christ, and we spend more time with that thing or with that activity than we do with Christ, we allow that to become an idol, and we begin to commit spiritual adultery. Amen. Because know ye not that you're married to Christ, you're married to the Lord, and now you are an adulterer. Amen. You cannot fornicate if you're a child of God. You cannot commit spiritual fornication. That's what the lost is doing, the unmarried lost. Are you with me? But we that are born again, if we are espoused unto Christ, if we've already been espoused to Christ, amen, and we're waiting to consummate the marriage, then we become as an adulterer, a spiritual adulterer, when we allow other things to take preeminence over Christ. Can somebody say amen? So he said, listen, that every one of you should know how to possess his vessel. In other words, you should have power over your body. You should know and learn how to beat this body, as it was stated this morning, and bring it into subjection to the Spirit. Come on, but if you're feeding it the poison of the world, if you're feeding it, amen, the message of the Antichrist, if you're feeding it from the news media outlets, amen, you will find yourselves contaminated, amen, with the spirits that are in this world. But I don't know about you, but we have to be very careful, amen, amen, to come out from among them and be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing. Come on, amen. We talk about rated R movies, amen, and not allowing those things in our living room, not allowing those bad curse words to come into our living room, not allowing the sewer of this world to come into our living room. But I, amen, I don't know about you, but I believe on the media we have to be very careful, because it is, amen, controlled by the spiritual wickedness in high places. Amen. It's controlled by principalities. Amen. The spirit of this world, amen, the God of this world, is trying to create a divide and a division. Amen. I'm telling you, he's preparing the way of the Antichrist. Come on. Amen. Even the false prophet has said same-sex marriage is okay. Amen. Abortions soon will be okay. Okay. Amen. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Amen. They'll go against the word of God, amen, and try to tell us that we've got to pay and support that. But I'm telling you, amen, we don't have to, amen, do it in the name of Jesus. We can make up our minds, God, I'm going to be pure. I'm going to be sanctified. I'm going to be holy. Hallelujah. I'm in the world, but I'm not of the world. Can somebody give him praise? Hallelujah. He said, every one of you should know how to possess your vessel in power. You've got to be very careful with your associations. You've got to be very careful with who you expose your spiritual man to. Amen. So he said, possess the vessel in sanctification and honor. Amen. You're a vessel, amen, in his hand to be used for his glory. You're a vessel that God wants to fill up, to be poured out unto others and into others. Amen. Are you understanding what I'm saying? God, he has set aside you and me as vessels, to be vessels of honor, to pour his spirit in us, to pour his glory in us, that we can be poured out unto others. Amen. He wants to, amen, to, amen, to flow his glory and his light through us. Can somebody give him praise? Hallelujah. He said, not in the lust of concupiscence, even as the Gentiles which know not God. In other words, let's don't be fornicators like the unbelievers or spiritual adulterers. Amen. Come on, amen. But we have to be very careful. Hallelujah. He said, he's not called us to uncleanness, but unto holiness. Come on, amen. Hallelujah. He said, the Gentiles which know not God, in other words, those who are still in Adam. Amen. And I'm not talking about my grandfather Adam. Come on, amen. In Adam, from the Garden of Eden, can somebody say amen? the father of all humanity. Hallelujah. When we're born in sin, David said. We're shapen in iniquity. Hallelujah. Amen. All of us like sheep have gone astray. Amen. Our righteousness, our good works and deeds are as filthy rags. That's why God sent his son, Jesus Christ. Amen. To be that propitiation. To be that vicarious sacrifice. Amen. Jesus came. Hallelujah. To bring about reconciliation of lost humanity with God. Hallelujah. He came to be that mediator between man and God. Hallelujah. And so God has not called us to uncleanness, amen, or to live after the flesh, but to holiness, to live after the Spirit, to abide in Christ. Amen. He said that ye may walk honestly towards them. In other words, being that epistle written and read of all men. Hallelujah. He said that that are without, amen, those that are not a part of the household of faith, and that ye may have lack of nothing. I like that. He said you don't have to have lack of nothing, because if you're sanctified and you're holy and you're pure, you can receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. You can receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. Can somebody say amen? Hallelujah. That you may have lack of nothing. Amen. Listen, you and I, we need the Holy Ghost in this time that we're living. Amen. You might say, well, I've got by so far, but I'm telling you, it's going to get worse. Amen. And you need the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. But I'm telling you, holiness always precedes Pentecost. When there have been great outpourings of the Spirit, of people being baptized or filled with the Spirit, it was always preceded by holiness, repentance, and turning back to God, and turning back to the Word of God. And so the message of the hour is purity and sanctification. God is calling us to separate ourselves from the world unto Him, that we might be a vessel of honor, meet for the Master's use, that He can pour into us, that we can pour into others. Can somebody give Him praise? Hallelujah. You know, a lot of folks never truly get born again. And I've made these statements before. And that's why there's no sanctification. Because you got to be justified before you can be sanctified. Come on, amen. But actually, like I said, you know, you're more sanctified, then that's the best time to receive the Spirit, to be filled with the Spirit. But amen, then there's progressive sanctification. There's maintenance of sanctification. That's demonstrated. I'll share that in a message later down the road in this series. Amen. Hallelujah. But understand what I'm saying. Amen. There's a lot of folks who never, amen, have been sanctified because they've never been justified. They've not been born again, amen. We've got a lot of charismatic churches, amen, that seem to be Pentecostal, but they're what some people are calling now neo-Pentecostal. Hallelujah, amen. And they're creating a bad reputation for those who are true, amen, living in holiness and truly filled with the Spirit of God. Actually, it's bringing a reproach against the true church, amen. Amen, because there's a charisma, there's a charismatic movement in church, amen, and they're living any kind of way and speaking in tongues, amen, and carrying about in churches, amen, amen, but there's no sanctification, and it creates confusion. Can somebody say amen? Confusion. So, amen, now we have Ishmaels born out of Hagar. Come on, amen. Hagar is just man-made religions. Come on, amen. Man-made religions, amen. And they're following after the flesh, and they're living in carnality, and yet they're speaking in tongues on Sunday morning and Wednesday night, and live like the devil all week long. Come on. Come on, amen. These things ought not to be. Hallelujah. Come on, amen. So purity and sanctification are essential. And thank God, amen, there is a progressive sanctification, and we must maintain our sanctification. Can somebody say amen? You see, people pray off conviction, and they never pray through to conversion. Let me say that one more time. People pray off conviction, but they never pray through to conversion. Come on, amen. Why have an imitation when you can have the genuine? Why have something that's not real when you can have the real thing? Come on, amen. Why not just pray through and touch. Come on. Amen. Why not pray through until you're converted? Hallelujah. Until you're justified. And you don't have to ask the pastor or somebody. Amen. I believe I'm saved. Am I saved? Come on. You will know. Amen. That you know that you've been born again. Can somebody give him praise? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You know, holiness is having a desire and also making an effort to honor God. That's what holiness is. Come on, amen. Come on, amen. Holiness is having a desire and making an effort to honor God. Are you with me? Nobody ever heard it defined like that, amen. But that's what holiness is. Holiness is, amen, desiring to honor God. Holiness is making effort to honor God. It's maintaining that sanctification. Amen. Amen. So listen, I don't know about y'all, but I want to be a wise virgin. I want to be a wise virgin. Come on, amen. I want to be a sanctified, wise virgin, because I believe the coming of the Lord could happen at any moment. Amen. I believe the Lord could come back before I finish this message. One day I'm going to say that and it's just going to happen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. But I want to be rapture ready. Can somebody say amen? Now let me do an illustration here. Somebody come help me hold the mic. Sister Charlene, can you help me hold the mic? I meant to get Brother Clay's mic, but that's all right. Amen. The demonstration that I've done about the cross. Amen. Can y'all hear me? This is like our life. Amen. And I've done this before, but not all of you have seen it. Amen. So this paper is like our life. You know, a heart, we have a dark side and we have a side that's of good. But it's also tainted with sin. Are y'all with me? Amen. So our heart is divided. But God wants us to take our lives and just put it in his hand. Amen. And then he'll begin to separate the dark side. You know, that's why I didn't have to ask anybody. That's why I didn't have to ask anybody, because, amen, I knew something had taken place inside. Come on, amen. I didn't have all the darkness on the other side. Now, I still had some issues that I needed to deal with. Are y'all with me? Come on, I still had some issues that I needed to deal with. Amen. Thank you, brother. Hallelujah. Just said it right there. So I still had some issues. Amen. So then I just put my life in the hand of God. Come on, amen. Hallelujah. I'm the clay and he's the potter. Are you with me? I'm the clay, so I can't tell the potter what to do with the clay. I've just got to yield myself in his hand. Come on, somebody help me. Hallelujah. And so as he begins to mold and shape my life, come on, it's not like I've been before. Footloose and fancy free. Come on, amen. But now my life is being formed and shaped, and I'm telling you, it's not easy sometimes. Amen. Some of the things that we're going through now, we never dreamed we would go through, my wife and I. Hallelujah. Amen. But I'm telling you, we're in the hands of God. It doesn't matter what kind of situation we're going through. It doesn't matter how life curves come against us, and amen, how things begin to bend us and bruise us and hurt us and prick us. Amen. Hallelujah. But I know that I'm in the hand of the potter. Hallelujah. Amen. My life is getting warped up. My life seems to be getting all bent out of shape. Hallelujah. Amen. But I'm telling you, God has a plan. I said, God has a plan. Amen. I don't understand it all, Brother Ashley, but I'm just you. Come on. He's pressing me. He's rubbing on me. Amen. He's shaping me. He's folding me. Amen. I thought I had arrived. Amen. Maybe a few years ago, but I'm telling you, amen, this year, 2020, has been a year, amen, of bending, amen.
amen, of bruising, amen, of breaking, come on, amen, of tearing, come on, amen, hallelujah. And I'm telling you, amen, things have been happening, and my life is being all turned topsy-turvy, as Brother Clay would say, amen. And I've got to, amen, but I've got to maintain my sanctification. I've got to maintain my purity. But how do I do it when my life is being bent and my life is being punctured and my life is being torn? Hallelujah. How do I stay on the straight and the narrow? How do I stay on the straight and the narrow way? Amen. Hallelujah. How do I keep myself from getting on the broad road? Are y'all with me? How do I keep myself from getting on the broad road? Amen. Hallelujah. It's a challenge. It's a battle. But I must maintain my sanctification. Amen. Come on. Amen. I'm telling you, if you stay on the broad road, this is what will happen. The devil will get you, and he'll tear your life to pieces. Amen. Are y'all with me? Hallelujah. So we've got to maintain the straight and narrow. We've got to walk in purity and in holiness. Come on, there's challenges that are coming against us. There's battles without and battles within. Come on, amen. It's not just, say, amen, a temptation to, amen, to drink a Budweiser. It's not just a temptation to light up a marijuana cigarette. It's not just a temptation, amen, to smoke a little bit of crack. Come on, amen. Shoot up the heroin. Come on, amen. It's not just a temptation to, amen, to run around with another woman or another man. Come on, amen. But I'm telling you, this is a battle of, amen, of hearing the devil saying, God don't love you. Amen. Why did God let this happen? Amen. Why is good things happen? Come on, even Christians will say, I don't understand it, brother. I don't know why this is happening to y'all. Amen. This should not be. Come on, amen. Why not? Why not? Come on, amen. I'm in this world, but I'm not of this world. And if God wants to do something special in me to touch somebody else's life, because we are epistles read of all men, and I refuse to go down that broad road, because the end of it is, amen, a torn up, messed up, raggedied up life. I'd rather maintain a life following after Jesus Christ. Amen. And you might say, brother, on the straight and the narrow road, amen, it's been hard. Yes, it's hard, because there's a cross that we have to bear. Jesus said, if you're going to be my disciple, you must deny yourself and take up your cross daily and follow me. Can somebody give him praise? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Now, Matthew chapter 7, verse 12 tells us this. It says, therefore, all things whatsoever ye would that men should do to you, unto you, do ye even so to them. Come on, amen. Do ye even so to them. Praise the Lord. He said, for this is the law and the prophets. What is he talking about? Treat other people the way you want to be treated. Love others the way you want to be loved. I'm telling you, it was all over. Brother Clay was all over it this morning. Amen. We cannot allow ourselves to be pushed and bent and shaped into the mold of the world. Come on. Amen. We cannot follow after, like I said earlier, the donkey or the elephant. But we've got to keep our focus on the Lamb. We've got to stay humble and holy, meek and lowly. We've got to follow after the Lord Jesus Christ. It doesn't matter if the fire's turned up seven times. It doesn't matter if the lions haven't been fed in a week. We've got to make up our mind. I'll keep on praying. I'll refuse to bow to the devil. I'll refuse to give in to the world. My mind's made up. Hallelujah. As somebody said, if hell comes against me, if high waters rise, I'm still holding to Jesus, because when the waves are over my head, they're still under his feet. Can somebody give him praise this morning? Hallelujah. So we can truly treat others with genuine love. Come on, amen. This world needs to experience a genuine love of God. Can somebody say amen? So he says in verse 13, enter ye in at the straight gate, the straight way, the narrow way. Amen. He said, wide is the gate. Wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. Amen. And many there be that go in thereat. Come on, it's easy on the broad road. Many folks are on the broad road. Come on, amen. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, people that walk with Christ, have renounced Christ and transgressed the blood of the covenant and walked on the blood of Jesus, treaded across the blood of Christ, and now they're walking in that broad way, but it's a way of destruction. Can somebody say amen? Hallelujah. He said, enter ye in at the straight gate. He said, for wide is the gate and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat. He said, because straight is the gate and narrow is the way. I'm preaching about purity and sanctification. Come on, amen. Hallelujah. I'm preaching about being peculiar. I'm preaching about being different. I'm preaching about not conforming to this world, but being transformed by the renewing of your mind. Hallelujah. Amen. By allowing this word of God, amen, to renew your mind, to help you, amen, to understand that my goal is to honor God. My goal is to please God. Can somebody say amen? Hallelujah. He said, because straight is the way of the gate and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life. Unto life. Do you hear that? One day, thank God, this world is not my home. Life is hard, but God is good. I said, life is hard, but God is good. Come on, amen. One day, Brother Donnie, I'll get to go to glory. And he'll say, well done, thou good and faithful servant. You've been faithful over a few things, now I'll make you ruler over many. Come on, I'll exchange this cross for a crown. Hallelujah. I'll take that crown and bow at the feet of Jesus and cast it at the feet of Jesus. Come on. And I'll declare with the angels of heaven, amen, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. I'll declare with the angels of heaven, worthy, worthy, worthy is the Lamb of God who was slain from the foundation of the world. Can somebody give him praise in his house? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And I'm already going over time. Amen. Can I just preach the word? Is that all right? Amen. Hallelujah. So basically, doing good is not enough. You must be born again. You must be justified. Amen. Hallelujah. You must be justified. Amen. So verse 17, he said, even so, every good tree of those who are in Christ bringeth forth good fruit. In other words, the fruit of the Spirit are manifest. He said, but a corrupt tree bringeth forth evil fruit, or the works of the flesh. A good tree cannot bring forth evil fruit, amen, neither can a corrupt tree bring forth good fruit. He said, every tree that bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. Come on, amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. He said, wherefore by their fruits ye shall know them. A tree that on the broad road you can do anything bears corrupt fruit, the works of the flesh. But a tree that is on the narrow way produces the fruit of the Spirit, is following after the Lord Jesus Christ. Are y'all with me? I'm going to grab this one. Amen. Are y'all with me? There you go. I got it, brother. Praise the Lord. So, amen. So, I don't know about you, but I want to be pure. I want to be sanctified. I want to be holy. Even though the cross is heavy, the way of the cross is hard. Amen. Hallelujah. But I want to honor my Heavenly Father. Can somebody say amen? Hallelujah. And he says here, listen. He says, not everyone. So, we've got to abide in Christ. Amen. And maintain the fruit of the Spirit. Come on. Amen. And that's the new birth is the key. Justification is the key. But we've got to maintain, amen, purity and sanctification. Hallelujah. We've got to maintain a lifestyle that brings honor and glory to our Heavenly Father. Can somebody say amen? He said those, amen, that are bearing the lust of the works of the flesh will be cast into the fire. He said, wherefore by their fruits ye shall know them. Amen. And then he goes on, not every one of that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven. But he that doeth the will of my Father. What is the will? This is the will of God concerning you, even your sanctification. Are you with me? Come on, amen. Hallelujah.
But he said, not everybody will go in. Many will say, Lord, Lord. He'll say, depart from me, for ye worker of iniquity, for I know you not. Amen. Hallelujah. But he said, but he that doeth the will of the Father. Don't you want to do the will of God? I said, don't you want to do the will of God? Amen. He said, which is in heaven. So just being good and doing good is not enough to get into heaven. Amen. You've got to be born again. And you've got to do God's will. It's no longer about you. It's no longer about me. It's all about Jesus Christ. It's all about the Lamb of God. It's all about fulfilling the works of Christ. Amen. We are His hands. We are His feet. And we're to manifest, amen, the gospel, to speak the gospel of Jesus Christ, and to manifest the light of Christ and the glory of our Heavenly Father. Can somebody say amen? Hallelujah. This is the will of God. Amen. Even your sanctification. So you know there's a broad road and there's a narrow road. Come on, amen. You're either in Adam or you're in Christ. Amen. Come on. Hallelujah. God's only looking at two people. He's only looking at Adam. And he's looking at Christ. Amen. So the question is, are you in Christ or are you in Adam? Are you with me? Those who are in Adam will go to the great white throne judgment. But those who are in Christ will stand before the judgment seat of Christ and be rewarded. Amen. Are you with me? Hallelujah. So there are two ways. So if you're in Adam, amen, you are partaker of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. Are you with me? You are partaker of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. This is the way of the flesh. This is the way of feeling. This is the way unto hell. Can somebody say amen? Come on, amen. Hallelujah. But if you're in Christ, then this is the tree, the way of the tree of life. Come on, amen. This is the way of the Spirit. This is the way of the Spirit. This is a faith walk. Come on, amen. You can't walk by feeling and still carry that cross. I said you can't walk by feeling and bear the cross. Amen. Must Jesus bear his cross alone? Come on, amen. You and I have been called to bear a cross. And I'm telling you, if we're going to bear this cross, we need the Holy Ghost to sustain us, to help us, to guide us, and to teach us. Can somebody say amen? Hallelujah. But if we unfold these, Sister Charlotte, you know how to unfold it? No? Amen? Anybody? You know how to unfold it? Bear with me just a moment. The broad road. The way of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. The way of feeling. Amen? Me? Everybody can see? It is the way of hell. Can somebody say amen? Y'all quiet. That makes me nervous. But anyway, it spells hell. So the broad road ends in destruction. The narrow road ends with a crown of life and a robe of righteousness. Hallelujah. But there is a responsibility to carry a cross and to maintain purity and sanctification. Are y'all hearing me? Hallelujah. God is calling us to maintain purity and sanctification, even while bearing our cross. Is that not what Jesus did? Come on, Jesus didn't just die on the cross. Oh, amen. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, the prostitutes came after him. The drug addicts came after him. The thieves came after him. The whoremongers came after him. Why did they come after Jesus? Why did they follow after Jesus? Because he died the same way that he lived, with his arms open wide. The cross is to remind us about our Lord. The daily taking up of our cross is to remind us, amen, that we're to follow his example of a life of sacrifice, a life of suffering, a life, amen, of joy and peace, yes, amen, but a willingness to take the wrong, a willingness to live with our arms open wide. Are you with me? Songwriter said, no wonder the prostitutes followed after him, because he lived the same way he died, with his arms open wide. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a hand of praise. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You see, there's two ways. There's the way of Cain. There's the way of Abel. There's the way of Esau. There's the way of Jacob. There's the way of King Saul, and there's the way of King David. There's the way of Judas, and there's the way of Peter. Think about those individuals. The ones that got it right had to endure a cross. Amen. The ones that got it wrong, they had a cross still. They still had hardness. They still had suffering. They still had problems. And look where they end up. I don't know about you, but I'd rather carry my cross for Christ, maintain my purity and sanctification, honoring the Lord. Amen. So in other words, the way of the flesh versus the way of the Spirit, the life of disobedience versus the life of obedience, a life in darkness versus a life in light, a life in Adam and a life in Christ. Amen. I'm closing right here. Psalm 24. Musicians, get ready. Psalms 24. Let me read this. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 10 tells us that we need to increase more and more. What does that mean? We need to become more and more like Christ. We need to maintain our purity and our sanctification. We ought to be, as we're walking on this narrow way, amen, we ought to be coming one with Christ. And that's only through maintaining purity and sanctification. Amen. Psalmist 24, he says, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein, for he hath founded it upon the seas and established it upon the floods. Who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord? Or who shall stand in his holy place? Amen. Come on, amen. It's not a going with the flow. It's not a going with the stream type of life, but it's going up the hill.
That's right.
Amen. Are you with me? Who will ascend the hill of the Lord? Who will maintain their purity and sanctification and bear their cross for Christ? Come on, amen. Hallelujah. It says, he that hath clean hands and a pure heart. Amen. Those that are born again, those that are in Christ, and those who have not lifted up his soul, amen, unto vanity, and nor sworn deceitfully. Verse 5, he shall receive the blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. So when we are born again, when we are justified, what a blessing that is. But also we shall receive righteousness, purity, sanctification, because grace is made available. The Holy Ghost makes his abode. Are y'all with me? Amen. So salvation brings about, amen, not just new life, but also a opportunity for sanctification, an opportunity for purity, amen, or holiness. Come on, amen. Amen. So he calls it, the psalmist calls it, the blessing and righteousness. Thank God, salvation, being justified, is a blessing. but also and righteousness, that's holiness, that's purity, that's sanctification, that's a life of sacrifice. Are you with me? Hallelujah. We got to get into the hill, onto the hill. We've got to get into the place of being crucified with Christ. Amen. We'll continue that this evening. Amen. Please leave it set up. Nobody touch it, if you will. Just come around and pray in just a moment. Let us stand together. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. God is good.
Yes, he is.
I said, God is good.
Yes, he is.
Amen. See, being born again is a blessing because now we have an enablement. We have an abundant grace that we have tapped into. Grace is simply enablement. Grace is simply, amen, an enablement to say yes, Lord, and to say no, devil, to say no, world, to say no, flesh. Amen. Grace is an enablement to a life of righteousness, a life of purity, a life that is sanctified, a life that is holy, set apart, a vessel of honor, meet for the master's use. Amen. God is looking for vessels that he can pour into, that he can pour out of. You know, the Bible talks about how that Israel had hewn out cisterns that could hold no water. They had cracks in their cisterns. They leaked out. Come on, amen. Come on, amen. I heard a preacher would come and run a revival. There's a young man praying in the altar, and he was praying. The evangelist was praying for the young man. And the young man was saying, Lord, save me and fill me with your spirit. Fill me with the Holy Ghost. And I mean, he'd do this every revival. He'd backslide, but every revival he'd come. And so that evangelist didn't know about it, amen. And he's praying for him, Lord, save him. Fill him with the Holy Ghost. And somebody said, be careful, he leaks. He's got a cistern that leaks. I don't know about you, but I don't want a cistern that leaks. Amen. But I want to maintain that oil of the Holy Ghost and that fruit of the Spirit. I want to maintain the joy of the Lord. Amen. Jesus said he wants to give us his joy that it might remain in us and that it might be full. Come on, amen. Hallelujah. It's up to us to maintain. It's up to us to maintain this purity and this sanctification. Amen. We're going to go on a journey for the next few services. Amen. Hallelujah. But I believe God wants to speak to us as the church. Amen. He's about to do something great. I believe he's preparing us for a harvest. I believe God's about to send some folks that don't look like us, don't act like us, and don't smell like us. Amen. But we got to love them like Jesus loves. Come on, amen. You used to be there. Come on, amen. Some of you were drunkards. Some of you were whoremongers. Come on, amen. Some of you were given to, amen, pornography. Come on, amen. Hallelujah. Some of you were addicted to drugs. Amen. But God had mercy. God had mercy. And we got to show the love of Christ. Father, we love you. We thank you, Lord.